With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hi everyone, let's take a question. So here the question is, how many asymmetric carbon atoms are present in? First is 1,2-dimethylcyclohexane, then 3-methylcyclopentene, then we have 3-methylcyclohexene, okay? So here we have to find out the asymmetric carbon. So asymmetric carbon atoms are those when the carbon atom, if we define it, a carbon atom which is bonded to the four different atoms or groups. Four different atoms or the groups in the molecule, and that is our asymmetric carbon, or we can say the chiral carbon, okay? And it is that carbon is also known to be the tetrahedral center, or we can say the chirality center, okay? So here first is our 1,2-dimethylcyclohexane. So we have the cyclohexane ring, okay? So here at the first position and at the second position we have the methyl groups. So now we want to know how many chiral centers, okay? So here if we consider this carbon, okay, so here one will be H and other is this group and other one is this, where we have methyl group attached, and this chain and this, it means here this carbon have the four different groups, so this is chiral. If we talk about now this, okay, so here we have one this whole chain and one hydrogen, one CH3, okay, because here we have three bonds we can see, so one will be hydrogen, okay, and one this chain, so it means here this is also chiral. But if we talk about this group, this carbon, here we can see that we will have the two hydrogens, right? Here we will have like one hydrogen, one, okay, so like this we will have the two hydrogens, okay? Here due to the attachment of the substituents we have the two chiral centers, that is this one and this one. So it means in the first we have two. Now next is our 3-methylcyclopentene. Here we have 3-methylcyclopentene. When we draw the cyclopentene structure, so that is this. Okay, so here at the third position we have the methyl group. Let it be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But how we know this is 1? Because here we have the double bond and here we have CH3. So now we want to know which one is our chiral carbon. Which one is our chiral carbon? Here this will not be chiral due to double bond. This will not chiral. This will not chiral. This one will be our chiral carbon, because if we talk about this bond, here we have one hydrogen, one this whole group, and from this side one and this CH3. So in this we have the one chiral center. Here like in the verb structure we will have the hydrogen, okay, like this. Now in the next, if we see, we have 3-methylcyclohexene. Okay, next is our 3-methylcyclohexene. So when we have this structure, at the third position methyl group, because at the first we have the double bond, so that's why it is the hexene, okay? So here if we see, it is same as the second, it will not be chiral, no, and no, this one will be only chiral carbon, okay? Due to the attachment of substituent, this is our chiral carbon, because one will be hydrogen here, okay, and one this group, one this and one this, so here also we have one. So it means we have the sequence, that is 2, 1 and 1. So here 201, 202, it is our correct answer, that is option number 1. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download doubtnet app today.